out of Compton. It's a crazy brother named Ice Cube.
Ele é o gangster original. Que articulou a raiva dos bairros pobres.
Ice Cube took you on a journey.
Cube would scare the shit out of you.
Ice Cube started gangster rap music. Straight up.
Ice Cube viveu uma infância marcada pela tragédia.
Barricaded herself in the back room with her. Then they heard gunshots.
They told us Beverly died. And we all start crying.
That's when I knew that the world that I was living in was a dangerous place.
The police coming straight from the underground. A young nigga got it bad cause I'm brown.
Ele provocou uma revolução musical com N.W.A.
I wanted to rap about stuff that was real.
When Fuck the Police came out, you know, that was how we felt.
Fuck the Police.
It was a voice to a lot of people who didn't have a voice.
I heard Payback's a brother on the trigger. That's why I'm...
Como artista solo, os raps de Ice Cube fizeram dele um homem marcado.
It's pornographic smut.
Damn about dissing these fools, cause they all scared of the Ice Cube.
The thing about my records, nobody's safe.
Então Ice Cube levou sua mensagem pro cinema.
What you say to that?
And I was just like, whoa.
Turn your punk ass off.
It's gonna be a good movie.
Ele se tornou um ator importante em Hollywood.
He went from, you know, the end that you love to hate to sort of the Bill Cosby of this generation.
Man, do not take my lunch money.
Mas o papel mais importante de Ice Cube tem sido como marido e pai dedicado.
I gotta say it was a good day.
From somebody who grew up in South Central to an empire, he's the best person that I have raised.
Agora, Ice Cube revela toda a sua rima. Além da atitude.
You either gotta have it or you don't, you know what I'm saying? And I happen to have it.
Por trás da expressão ameaçadora, esta é sua história em Behind the Music.
This is my town, I run it, you walk it.
That whiz, I rep that whiz, I rep that whiz.
De março de 2011. Ice Cube está em sua cidade natal, Los Angeles.
The voice is fucked up, get a hold. Especially all y'all dudes out there smoking them blunts. Get you one, bro.
Nos bastidores, antes de um show em House of Blues, Cube relaxa com parentes e amigos.
To witness the strength.
Let's go, come on.
Get on up, get on up.
Let's go,
get on up.
Where you coming from?
Straight out of Compton. Crazy motherfucking name, Ice Cube. From the gang called niggas with attitude.
Aos 42 anos, Cube ainda comanda o palco.
So when I'm in your neighborhood, you better go, y'all. Cause Ice Cube is crazy as fuck, y'all.
E faz rap com sua lendária ferocidade. Mas agora, seus dois filhos, Doug Boy e OMG, o acompanham.
Give it up for my two sons, OMG and Doug Boy. A chip off the old Q. We doing a little something like this, LA. Rock with me, baby.
I never thought they'd be rocking with me. I always pictured them little, you know what I'm saying? You never picture them when they bigger than you. And they got skills, you know what I'm saying?
As soon as you hear that music, you're OMG, you're a rapper now. This isn't Dad, this is Ice Cube. You gotta rock it.
I rap that word, I rap that word.
Ice Cube, baby!
Mas fora dos holofotes, o padrinho do rap gangster foge da festa e volta para sua família.
It's probably somebody somewhere in the club mad at me because I'm at home with my family. But for the most part, I'm gonna do what I want to do. I ain't living for nobody but myself and my family.
Ice Cube sempre foi um homem de família. O'Shea Jackson nasceu em 1969 e cresceu em South Central, Los Angeles.
What's up, homie? Let's see what you're working with here. Let me get one of these squeeze pops. There used to be a lot of kids on the block.
All the kids done moved away. I guess we grew up. We was the kids.
Well, this is the house I grew up in. Got a nice fresh paint job.
O pai de Cube era jardineiro e a mãe era zeladora. Eles o criaram com os valores da classe trabalhadora.
O'Shea always was a good person and funny.
He was a good kid. You know, I never did have any problem riding him.
By me having my father there, he taught me how to be a man. He taught me how to be a leader and not a follower.
Para o jovem O'Shea, South Central parecia como qualquer outro bairro de Los Angeles.
I thought we was rich, you know what I mean? Because the neighborhood at first glance looks like a pristine place to be. It seems pretty quiet around here, but I guess the freaks come out at night.
Em 1981, O'Shea foi exposto à realidade de seu bairro pela primeira vez, quando sua meia-irmã, Beverly, foi assassinada a poucos quarteirões de distância. Ela tinha apenas 22 anos.
Her husband was depressed and just came back one day and barricaded herself in the back room with her. Then they heard gunshots.
We got up to the house and they told us Beverly died. And we all started crying. And I'll never forget that day. She loved O'Shea. She was crazy about O'Shea.
That's when I knew that the world that I was living in was a dangerous place. I started hardening myself to that by that age, you know, especially when it hit so close to home.
Em meados de 1980, a epidemia do crack começou a assolar South Central, transformando o tranquilo bairro numa zona de guerra. E para os moradores locais, a polícia só piorava a situação.
We felt the pressure from was the police harassing people, so nobody trusted the police.
Mas enquanto outros entraram para gangues, O'Shea tramou uma estratégia de saída mais positiva.
I always got off on being constructive and not destructive.
O hip hop parecia ser a saída. No segundo ano do ensino médio, ele começou a escrever raps. E começou a se intitular Ice Cube, um apelido que seu irmão havia lhe dado porque ele era bacana com as mulheres.
My name is Ice Cube and I want you to know I'm not Run DMC or Curtis Blow. That was the first line I ever wrote. That right there, you know, it was the jump off.
Em 84, Cube se juntou ao vizinho Sir Jinx, formando um grupo chamado CIA.
That was Jinx's house right there. We used to be in that garage right there, getting down.
Cube is a writer that can become a chameleon. So he was able to take everybody's story and implement it in a rhyme.
Ice Cube in effect, and I'm the bossy leader. Love my woofer and hate my tweeter.
It was really about party rapping at that time. Do we want to rap about stuff that was fly, you know what I mean? That was the style.
West Coast style.
Cube conseguiu sua primeira grande chance quando Jinx o apresentou a seu primo, Andre Young, que era um DJ local conhecido como Dr. Dre.
Had a barbecue in this house right here. I met Dre for the first time. Back there, he heard me rhyme. The rest is not only history, but it's the future.
We became real close friends. We started hanging out a lot. What he would do is come up to the spots that I was DJing and MC sometimes.
Em 86, Dre apresentou Cube a seu amigo de infância, Eric Easy Wright. Ele era um ex-traficante de crack que queria se tornar um agente musical.
Before I was doing records, I was into everything myself, and the, you know, the gangs, the drug situation, everything.
Easy, you know, I looked up to him in a lot of ways because he was progressively trying to figure out how to make it and how to better his situation.
Impressionado com as composições de Cube, Easy encomendou uma música para um grupo de rappers de Nova York que ele agenciava, chamado HBO.
And brought it back to Dre and everybody, and they all was in there. I rapped it to them. And HBO was like, can't rap that. He talking about 6'4 Chevys, ganking people. We from Queens. We don't know about this.
Dr. Dre procurou Easy, que nunca tinha feito rap antes, e pediu que ele tentasse gravar.
And when he learned to rhyme, Eazy-E was born. And then Cube was introduced as a writer.
Boys in the Hood se tornou um grande sucesso local, acrescentando uma nova perspectiva ao hip-hop e praticamente criando sozinho o gênero do rap gangster.
The fellas out there making that dollar, I pulled up in my 6-4
Impala. When I first heard Boys in the Hood, I was like, somebody speaking for us. That was something I was like, whoa, we got something here.
L.A. Gangs wasn't the topic that you heard a lot about in the late 80s, but they brought that to the forefront.
Little did he know I had a loaded 12 gauge. One sucker did L.A. Times front page.
We started looking at this as our niche. We had the hottest record on the street, and people wanted more.
Em 1988, MC Ren e DJ Yella se juntaram a Dre, Easy e Cube, formando um grupo de hip-hop das estrelas locais. Eles escolheram um nome polêmico.
You know, what we gonna call this group? And I was like, what? It's the N.W.A. Like, what that means? It's the niggas with attitudes. I just fell out. I said, I love it. I said, hell yeah. Black people taking that word and trying to use it instead of getting abused by it.
A seguir, o ataque de Ice Cube à polícia irrita alguns.
Here was a way where we could take all that pain, frustration, put it on a song and scream it.
Mais tarde, Cube se afasta do N.W.A.
Everyone was telling him, oh, you left the biggest group ever. You made a mistake. You a fool.
Na volta de Behind the Music.
Boys in the hood are always home.
Em 1988, Ice Cube era membro do N.W.A., um grupo de estrelas liderado por um traficante de drogas que virara rapper, chamado Eazy-E.
Yo, I'm Eazy.
And we're N.W.A.
Say Compton's in the
house. Warren, say hello
to Eazy. Eazy criara Ruthless Records com o agente Jerry Heller, que acreditava que havia descoberto o próximo sucesso depois de ouvir suas demos.
I just thought the power of it was something that was a lot different than anything I had heard before.
I felt like he was this white dude that was pretending to love us. If you wanted to put a picture of shady management, here's the picture.
Apesar de desconfiar do agente, Ice Cube entrou no estúdio com o N.W.A. em março de 88, onde passaram 6 semanas e gastaram $8,000 gravando Straight Outta Compton.
You are now about to witness the strength of street knowledge.
Lançado pela Priority Records em agosto de 88, o disco mudou a cara do hip hop.
Here was a group that was rapping about stuff that we all knew and we were living.
So when I'm in your neighborhood, you better duck down, cause Ice Cube a damn so fuck 'em down. As I leave, believe I'm stomping, but when I come back, boy, I'm coming straight out of Compton.
Ice Cube brought that voice of aggression, you know, of that anger.
Easy as his name and the boys coming
right out of Compton.
Everybody else was making this popcorn music, and we just came from the streets, and people just like, wow.
When you think of N.W.A., you just think of the truth.
That's the way it goes in the city of Compton, boy.
Mas na época, o país não suportava a verdade. Primeiro, o vídeo foi banido da MTV.
MTV can't handle it.
Devido ao que a emissora chamou de conteúdo violento.
They play a lot of rock and roll, you know what I'm saying, with the satanic stuff. And the Madonna, she can get on there half naked. But when they see something real, they want a bandage.
Ice Cube, take the motherfucking stand.
E a polêmica foi apenas o começo. A faixa mais polêmica do disco, escrita por Ice Cube, era uma acusação à brutalidade policial nos bairros pobres.
The police coming straight from the underground. A young nigga got it bad, cause I'm brown.
When Fuck the Police came out, that was how we felt.
We ain't talking about all police, man, but there's bad police out there.
They have the authority to kill a minority. No, that is because I ain't the one for a punk motherfucker with a badge and a gun to be beaten on.
people were getting killed by the police. They were getting beat by the police. There were no repercussions.
Here was a way where we could take all that pain, frustration, put it on a song and scream it.
It's gonna be a bloodbath of cops dying in L.A. Yo, Dre, I got something to say.
A música provocou protestos de críticos conservadores.
These people aren't doing anything but capitalizing off of death and violence.
O FBI tomou uma medida extrema, enviando uma carta para Priority Records e acusando o NWA de incentivar a violência contra a polícia.
The FBI has your name. You know you're making a difference.
Like, whoa, okay. We touched a nerve. Now let's see what else we can do.
And then everything just exploded from there.
Mesmo tocando poucas vezes no rádio e sem a exibição de seu vídeo, Straight Outta Compton virou disco de ouro em 4 semanas, vendendo 3 milhões de cópias.
The critics are talking about the group all they want. We're gonna keep doing what we're doing because people like it.
No verão de 89, Ice Cube e o NWA se tornavam popstars.
How hard-boiled are these guys? Well, the initials stand for niggers with attitude.
E a MTV foi forçada a ceder a popularidade.
Yo, I'm Eazy-E.
And we're NWA.
Chilling out with NWA and Compton. What's up, y'all?
Motherfucker coming straight out of Compton. That's the motherfucker man, Ice Cube. From the gang, yo, niggers with attitude.
O NWA lançou uma turnê nacional e a estrada se tornou um paraíso de festas e mulheres.
Everything. Guns, weed, women.
What's the best thing that's been happening at the party so far? We just got here a little late.
Women!
Back then it was just, you know, anything goes.
But a nigga like Brandon from the gangster dips right out of Compton.
Mas enquanto outros membros da banda perdiam o controle, Ice Cube se transformava num homem de uma só mulher. Naquele verão, ele conheceu Kimberly Woodruff e os dois logo começaram a namorar.
It was just kind of like we were looking for each other all this time.
He felt like, okay, this is someone who has my back, you know, and she's gonna always have my back.
E Cube precisaria de apoio ao entrar em uma disputa financeira com o NWA e o agente Jerry Heller. Em 89, Cube alegava que havia recebido apenas $32,000 em royalties.
He just didn't feel that he was getting a fair share for what he was contributing to the success of those records.
Success changed your life at all? I mean, have you gone out and bought a Mercedes yet, or did?
Nah, man. I still got me a little Jeep. I'm at my mother's house.
I think that he got what someone at his stage of his career would have gotten.
Numa encruzilhada, Cube se voltou à única pessoa em quem podia confiar.
I didn't know if I was gonna leave or I was gonna stay. And Kim, she was like, believe in yourself and your ability. And we'll roll whatever happened after that.
No final de 89, Ice Cube decidiu deixar o NWA. E a ruptura levou ao rancor.
We were looking at him at the time like, you know, you're turning your back on the group.
That was the last I've seen of him for years.
How have things changed since Ice Cube left?
Better.
Yeah, it got better. For real. You know, because ain't no ego trips in the group anymore.
I just realized there's no way to keep this friendship together if the business went so sour.
A seguir, Ice Cube torna-se o mais procurado do país.
It's just pornographic smut.
Some women want to act like bitches and hoes. What else you gonna call?
Mais tarde, a carreira cinematográfica de Ice Cube quase termina antes de começar.
He sucked. It was just so bad. I'm thinking like, you know, I'm totally unqualified for this.
Na volta de Behind the Music. Em 89, Ice Cube deixou o NWA no auge do sucesso devido a uma disputa financeira.
I think we all thought, okay, he's done.
Everyone was telling him, oh, you left the biggest group ever. You made a mistake. You a fool.
I had to break, man, because I'd rather start from scratch, man, than build something, man, and it come crumbling down.
Cube precisou provar que podia seguir sozinho. Então ele recrutou os produtores do Public Enemy, The Bomb Squad, como coprodutores. e foi para Nova York no final de 89 para gravar seu disco solo de estreia.
Nobody gets the air till
he ain't got no audio.
He had a lot to prove, he had a lot of baggage and he had a lot of pressure.
He came to our spot with 8 composition books full of rhymes and lyrics and songs and ideas. This was incredible.
I've never seen anybody so committed. I mean, he came into my studio and slept on the floor for 3 days.
I wanted to not just rap, but rap about stuff that was real.
Yo, this sound,
gonna be dope.
All right. We out.
Lançado em 16 de maio de 1990, America's Most Wanted era uma declaração das linhas de frente dos bairros pobres. Repleto de humor negro e honestidade brutal.
It's pure unadulterated cue. It's playful, it's funny, it's dangerous.
Who's the Mac? Is it that fool that's in the club accent? Have you ever been in a hot tub?
This record was the street's favorite record.
Don't try to apprehend him.
Ice Cube took you on a journey. And for if you were unaware, now when you ride through the hood, you understand now.
It's time to take a trip to the suburbs. Let them see a nigga invasion. Point blank.
I'm America's most wanted by the system because they don't want me doing what I'm doing. And I'm America's most wanted by the fans because they down with what I'm doing.
O primeiro single dominou as paradas de rap e America's Most Wanted virou platina em 3 meses. Mas as letras explícitas de Cube enfureceram os grupos feministas.
I'm all for freedom of speech, but when stuff like this, I think that's crossing the line.
It's just pornographic smut.
You know what the fuck you think you want, color girls and bitches? You ain't all that. That's all I get. Bitch, bitch. I ain't nobody's bitch.
Cube não pediu desculpas e alegou que estava sendo realista.
If you don't act like the record says, you shouldn't get offended.
I don't give a fuck about dissing these fools because they all scared of the Ice Cube.
Some women want to act like bitches and hoes. They gotta be put in that category. What else you gonna call?
Enquanto Cube era atacado pelos grupos feministas, ele se dedicava exclusivamente à namorada Kim Woodruff, sua namorada há 2 anos.
She's just the perfect woman, friend, confidant, partner.
Cube e Kim ficaram noivos em 1990 e ela deu à luz a seu primeiro filho, O'Shea Jr., em fevereiro de 91.
When you have a baby, you have to make sure they have a chance to be successful. That's your job.
E Cube levou essa responsabilidade a sério, especialmente quando se tratava de transações financeiras com seu selo, a Priority Records.
My son was 5 days old and I was expecting an advance so I could buy a new house for my family. And I got a bullshit excuse on why it wasn't coming down the pipe.
That was kind of a misunderstanding that we had and we didn't quite communicate as well as we should have.
Então, Cube deixou seu tom de beisebol resolver tudo.
I went up there with a bat and just tore up the office. There was a lot of glass everywhere. I had a few of the homies with me and it was just ugly. I had an aluminum bat. It was bent when I left.
He did me a huge favor by basically destroying the television and forced me to get a new TV, which he'd been bugging me to do for years.
Cube recebeu o adiantamento e algumas semanas depois, mais boas notícias. Um diretor estreante chamado John Singleton queria escalá-lo para o filme Os Donos da Rua, que era inspirado na música visceral de Cube. Mas no teste, Cube quase destruiu sua carreira de ator antes mesmo de começar.
My manager said, yo, these pages came in. You read tomorrow. All right. Took the pages, folded them up, put them in my back pocket. Never looked at them.
We sat him down, he read it and everything, and it's like, he sucked. I said, you didn't read this, did you? He said, no, I didn't read it. I've been touring. And I said, man, you got to go read this. Just go read the script and come back.
So when I read it, I'm like, oh, they're about to do a movie about how we grew up. I'm perfect for this.
What do you think of Dope Boy?
He's high. I know a lot of guys like him. Uh-huh. You know, that live around my block. Uh-huh. So, you know, this whole script kind of hits home when you after you read the whole thing, you know.
And so he came in and he started doing his thing.
See me? I get more pussy than you probably get air with your wannabe Mac Daddy ass.
He was Doughboy.
Yo, motherfucker, what you say to that? Domino, motherfuckers. What you say about that?
I was just like, whoa, it's gonna be a good movie.
Lançado em julho de 91, Os Donos da Rua se tornou um marco cinematográfico. E transformou Ice Cube numa estrela de cinema.
Turn your punk ass off!
The ease in which he kind of exhibited movie star charisma and held the screen like, oh, where have you been? Like, you know, you should have been acting for years.
Either they don't know, don't show, or don't care about what's going on in the hood.
It was a great experience, man, and I just wanted to do more movies. It's hard to match a classic like Boys in the Hood, but, you know, we're gonna keep trying.
I said, yeah. Cube se despede de velho amigo.
We talked for hours, and we was talking about putting the group back together, and then that was the last time I seen him alive.
Na volta de Behind the Music. Em 1991, Ice Cube dominava o mundo do rap e sua estreia solo lhe rendera um disco de platina.
So how's it going now? Everything's straight, platinum.
Mas, como pai, ele buscava um significado mais profundo para a vida. E começou a se interessar pela nação do Islã, um movimento espiritual que aspirava à melhoria das condições sociais e econômicas das minorias no país.
This was a whole different approach of, we in it together, we got to get out of it together. You have to try to live the right way. That turned me on.
Apesar de nunca ter se afiliado à nação do Islã, Cube se tornou um muçulmano e mostrou uma perspectiva mais política em seu segundo disco, Death Certificate, que falava da situação dos bairros pobres.
It's all about our situation. If we don't change our situation, we might as well sign our own death certificate already.
I became a person who thirsts knowledge and tried to seek it out. And I realized some of these things should be said in the music.
Stop selling out your race. And wipe that stupid looking smile off your face.
O ponto de vista lírico de Cube tornou-se mais ligado às questões sociais e à injustiça política.
Cube kind of started making the transition from being gangster rapper to gangster politician.
You only got yourself to blame. Get a grip, Oreo, and be true to the game.
He turned around from being, you know, the cat that was always with the gangster shit to coming on saying, yo, let's look at how we living right now.
That's how we doing it in 92. Fool, be true to the game.
Do you think you set a good example for the young people today? Well, I think I do, because I speak the truth. I tell the real deal.
I'm gonna treat you like king.
What king?
Like Martin Luther King, like Rodney King, like all the kings from Africa.
Los Angeles era um barril de pólvora quando Death Certificate foi lançado em outubro de 91. O espancamento de Rodney King ainda era uma ferida aberta e as tensões raciais aumentavam. Em 29 de abril de 1992, os quatro policiais acusados pelo espancamento de Rodney King foram absolvidos.
We, the jury, in the above entitled action, find the defendant, Stacy C. Coon, not guilty.
I was like, damn, I thought we had come so much further than that.
By having this verdict, what these people done, they lit the fuse to a bomb.
Los Angeles explodiu em três dias de tumultos violentos, causando $1 bilhão em prejuízos e 55 mortes.
This is a frustration with an injustice, and there was no other way to vent the frustration.
These cops beat this man on camera, and you're telling us that they're justified. That's what made the riots jump off.
He looked like a prophet after the riots. He told you it was coming.
Every major news organization was banging down the door, trying to ask, like, how did you know?
I just want to say, you know, can we all get along?
I didn't have nothing nice to say. You know, I didn't have that can we all get along speech at that time in me. I was pretty much witty.
Após as críticas às suas rimas pesadas, Ice Cube decidiu baixar o tom da retórica em seu lançamento seguinte, The Predator.
Is it a good day?
So far.
So far, so good.
Today I didn't even have to use my AK. I gotta say it was a good day.
Was a Good Day foi uma mudança notável para Ice Cube. E o single foi aceito nas rádios convencionais, dominando as paradas pop.
Even saw the lights of the Goodyear blimp, and it read Ice Cube's a pimp.
I had people in my camp saying, you can't do that record. You do hardcore gangster rap. That record is talking about a good day. I said, well, you know, that happens too. You know, neighborhood ain't a war zone.
Cause nobody I know got killed in South Central LA. Today was a good day.
A música também refletia as boas vibrações na vida pessoal de Cube.
When you live in this so-called American dream, I did want to celebrate a little bit and say, hey, you know, this is what it's all about.
And everything is all right. I got a beat from Kim, and she could do it all.
Em 92, ele se casou com Kim Woodruff, a mãe de seu filho.
She's the perfect person for him because she balances him out so. Very wise woman, very kind.
If it really wasn't for her, I don't know if I'd be sitting here today as the man I am.
Enquanto Cube vivia como marido e pai, ele esperava acabar com sua rivalidade com NWA. E uma oportunidade surgiu em 94. Quando ele se deparou com Easy E num clube de Nova York.
We talked for hours and we was talking about putting the group back together. The club ended up closing and we both were stranded. Cav wasn't picking us up and he started walking and that was the last time I seen him alive.
Quatro meses depois, Eric Easy Wright morreu de complicações decorrentes da AIDS. Ele tinha 31 anos.
Eric Wright went on to life support on the 15th of March. He was under heavy sedation and unconscious at the time of his death.
Cube optou por não participar do funeral. Ele disse que não queria se despedir de Easy dessa forma.
I feel good that I didn't see him laid up in the hospital and I didn't see him laid up in the casket. I like the vision of him walking away, you know what I mean? With the New York City backdrop. That to me is a better goodbye than seeing him laid up.
Ice Cube se torna um magnata de Hollywood.
You either gotta have it or you don't, you know what I'm saying? And not having a habit.
There's very few people get to do that in Hollywood, actually hold the reins and control what it is that you're doing.
Oh, man, I'm tripping.
Na volta de Behind the Music. Aos 25 anos, Ice Cube tinha alcançado enorme sucesso como ator e rapper.
So what you gonna do when you get out of jail? I'm gonna have some fun with the pop gun.
Ele tinha lançado 3 discos de platina. E participado de uma série de filmes de sucesso, incluindo Os Donos da Rua, de John Singleton.
I got bit by the bug, and John was like, it's gonna be hard for you to find something like Boys in the Hood, unless you probably write it yourself. So I'm like, whoa, what?
He would ask me, how do you write a script? And I was like, man, you know, you write songs, you can write a script.
Took the Boys in the Hood script, saw the format, and just started trying to write a script.
Em 94, Cube escreveu um roteiro de comédia sobre um grupo de amigos em South Central e o apresentou a New Line Cinema.
Immediately, you kind of, you roll your eyes, go, oh, another actor is writing a script. And then the guy just came in and just told a great story.
Lançado em abril de 95, Sexta-feira em Apuros, estrelado por Cube e Chris Tucker, se tornou um enorme sucesso e mostrou as habilidades cômicas do rapper.
What's up?
Are you hot?
Huh?
Are you hot?
No, why you say that?
Because you look like you've been smoking.
What the fuck?
I remember reading the script. I'm like, oh my God, this is so funny. This is so silly. This is so real.
Oh, man, I'm tripping.
Saw Boys in the Hood, people saw South Central and all these things that was just showing that. It's like, damn, y'all act like we lived in the pit of hell. You know what I'm saying? And it wasn't like that. We cried, but we laughed more than we cried.
Com um orçamento de apenas 3 milhões de dólares, Sexta-feira em Apuros arrecadou 10 vezes esse valor. De repente, Ice Cube era um legítimo artista de Hollywood.
That's when Hollywood said he is someone who can act, he can, you know, write, he can do all of this.
Cube usou sua influência com sabedoria e estreou na direção com Clube dos Imorais. Estrelou o aclamado filme Três Reis.
You either got a habit or you don't, you know what I'm saying? And I happen to have it.
E depois fundou sua própria produtora, a Cube Vision.
You see Cube Vision, you know, I wanted to be hands-on, you know, really my vision.
A produtora lançou a sequência de Sexta-feira em Apuros e o grande sucesso Uma Turma do Barulho.
Who drank my goddamn apple juice?
Oh, Terry. Stop cussing, this ain't Def Comedy Jam.
I tried to show a candid look at, you know, at a little crack in the world that people don't usually get a chance to see, but so much action happens there.
This is the barbershop, the place where a black man means something. Cornerstone neighborhood.
He is very clever on the choices of the movies he makes, but there's very few people get to do that in Hollywood, actually hold the reins and control what it is that you're doing.
Enquanto subia no mundo do cinema, Cube ainda tinha tempo para seu primeiro amor, a música. Em War and Peace, volume 2, ele se juntou aos ex-colegas de banda, Dr. Dre e MC Ren, na faixa Hello. A nova formação do N.W.A. encabeçou a turnê Up in Smoke Tour com Snoop Dogg no lugar de Eazy-E.
I'm just gonna go up there and do my part and support the movement.
Make some noise for Eazy-E.
We feel like family out here, you know, once again, unfortunately without my man Eazy-E, but he's damn sure looking down on this and saying, yo, this is how I wanted y'all to do it.
They call me the Don Dada, pop a collar, drop a dollar, if you hear me, you can holler.
Falou-se em gravar um novo disco, mas eles perceberam que não poderia haver um N.W.A. sem Eazy.
I think we all collectively decided to put it to bed that without Eazy, nobody will really accept this as N.W.A.
Are you having a good motherfucking time?
Em duas décadas, Ice Cube havia se transformado de rebelde de bairro pobre a astro de Hollywood. Mas seu papel mais duradouro era o pai de seus quatro filhos, OMG, Doughboy, Karina e Sharif.
I think I am firm but fair. You know, I'm always give fatherly advice.
I even saw the lights at a Goodyear blimp and it ran.
From somebody who grew up in South Central, you know, that didn't necessarily have a lot, to an empire, he's the best person to have raised you.
We come in peace, y'all.
Em 2005, Cube canalizou sua experiência como pai numa jogada surpreendente.
You got somebody bothering you at school or something?
He's an asthmatic in the accelerated program. What do you think?
Ele produziu e estrelou o blockbuster familiar.
Try this. It's foolproof.
Querem acabar comigo?
No, no, no. Check the lip. Check the lip. Man, do not take my lunch money.
He's more like a little rougher than are we there yet. He doesn't go for too much BS.
And the controversy was the fact that I did a movie for kids. Like, I can't do a damn movie for some little badass kids. That's funny.
Com uma sequência de sucesso e na TV, Ice Cube era apresentado a uma nova geração de fãs.
Ice Cube transformed from, I mean, the toughest gangster rapper to, you know, kind, friendly. He could do a Jell-O commercial right now. I was sure of it.
He went from, you know, the end that you love to hate to sort of the Bill Cosby of this generation.
It's my town. I run it. You walk it. You just now learning the game.
Cube did it on his own. He did everything by himself because he knew that his instincts were better than anybody else's.
I think I've been able to balance artist and entertainer and still
Give the people what I want, but be myself.
Cube agora ajuda os filhos a entrarem pro negócio. Seus filhos mais velhos, Dog Boy e OMG, o acompanham em seu novo disco e na turnê.
They've been around music all their life. What I love about them is they go and do their own music. They don't just wait for me. And they're good. They're damn good, man.
He told us one night, you don't know how happy I am to be up here with you two. So, you know, it means a lot to him.
Mas após mais de duas décadas, Ice Cube insiste que está apenas se aquecendo.
He tells us there's no reason for him to retire as long as he has a tongue in his mouth. As long as I can still speak my, you know, my thoughts, why stop?
It ain't gonna stop with Cube. It don't stop. I'm letting y'all know. I know I'm better than a lot of y'all out there. It ain't gonna stop. We love being up close and personal with the fans, and it is what it is.
I got a lot to do. I'm barely halfway through my career. Barely. I'm a monster. West Side Locksmith. I'm a problem. My to-do list is always to get better at everything. I could be a better father, husband, brother, son, rapper, actor, producer. A writer, you know, if I do that, everything hopefully it'll take care of itself.
Thanks for coming to rock with your boy Ice Cube. We love you, motherfuckers, forever and a day, baby. One more time before we get out of here, let me hear you. Oh, yeah, yay! Peace, we love you.
Doing my own life. And if you got a problem with that, then it go, go, go. And I be everywhere on the map, but I rep that West.
Nevada,
I rep that West.
Oklahoma, Colorado, Utah,
Oregon,
Washington, New Mexico.
Yeah.
Y'all know what it is? Is this too West Coast?